Hey, it's Kaylee. In this lesson, we will learn to find the area of polygons. Remember that polygons can be regular, meaning the side lengths are equilateral, or they can be irregular, where the side lengths can be different sizes. The way we find the area for both of these is different. When we have an irregular polygon, like this pentagon, we don't have a go-to formula to find the area. So we have to decompose it into different shapes so that we do have formulas. Decomposing a figure into different shapes means we take our big shape and break it into smaller shapes that fit inside. When you look at this pentagon, do you see other shapes inside of it? We can draw a line right here and turn this pentagon into a triangle and a trapezoid. Now the area of this pentagon is equal to the area of the triangle plus the area of the trapezoid. And we know the formula for triangles is base times height divided by 2. And the area for trapezoids is base 1 plus base 2 times the height over 2. So now I have my values for my pentagon, and I can see how those values would fit into the formulas for my triangle and my trapezoid. Let's do the triangle first. The base of my triangle is going to be the red line here, and it has a value of 5. And the height of this triangle is that right angle line to the opposite vertex, 2. So I can find the area for my triangle is going to be 5 times 2 divided by 2, which is going to give me 10 over 2, which is going to give me 5. So that's the area for my triangle. Now let's find the area for my trapezoid. So my trapezoid has a base of 5, which I know up here, and another one of 3 down here. So I'm going to have base 1, 5, plus base 2, 3. Is multiplied by what's the height of my trapezoid. Remember, it's a right angle here going to the opposite vertex, 4 divided by 2. And this is going to give me 5 plus 3 gives me 8. 8 times 4 is 32 over 2. That's going to be equal to 16. So now if I take the area of my triangle and I add it to the area of my trapezoid, I'll have the area for this entire pentagon. So the area for my pentagon is equal to 5 plus 16. And that is equal to 21. Great job. Now what about finding the area of a regular polygon, like this heptagon? The first thing we do is decompose our shape into congruent triangles. That means I can't use diagonals to make triangles, since those triangles are different sizes and shapes. Instead, I start at each vertex and draw a line to the center point of my shape. So now I have 7 triangles, and I do know how to find the area of triangles. Area equals 1/2 the base times the height. But these are not right triangles. So what's the height of these triangles? Yeah, we need to find the distance from the base to the opposite vertex with a right angle. We call this distance the apothem. The distance from the center of a regular polygon to the side at a right angle represents the height of the triangles. We also call the height of the triangles the apothem. So now that I have the height of my triangles, I know the area of my heptagon is going to be 7 times the area of one triangle. But do you notice something about the base of the triangle, B? It is the same as the side length of our heptagon. And the side length times the number of sides, 7, is the perimeter of the heptagon. So I can rewrite the formula for my heptagon as area equals 1/2 times perimeter times height. But since we aren't relying on our triangle anymore, we can call the height the apothem. So now that I know this, I can rewrite my formula for the area of a heptagon for any polygon. The area of a polygon is 1/2 times the perimeter times the height, or the apothem. So let's find the area of this regular polygon together. Here I have my formula, area equals 1/2 times the perimeter times the apothem. Now I already know my apothem here. It's that distance at a right angle to the center. So this is gonna be 7. And what is my perimeter? I have to count how many sides I have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the number of sides is 6 times the length of one side is 8. So that's my perimeter. And then 1/2 of that. All right, so my perimeter, 6 times 8, that gives me 48. And I can divide 48 by 2, that's gonna give me 24, and I still have to multiply that by 7, which if you don't know off the top of your head, you can use a calculator for. 24 times 7 is 168. So that is the area of this regular hexagon. Great job learning the techniques for finding the area of regular and irregular polygons. Practice what you've learned by playing the online games and quizzes. Have fun and remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.